She's got a seminar this weekend too. She's training people. Is she training people in the ring how to ref or how to wrestle?
No. It's a virtual training. I forgot about that. Every day's a gift.
This might be an impromptu gift indeed.
Should I run?
I want to know how much it costs for this training.
$35. I already saw the ad for it. $35. So
$35 American or £35?
I don't know. It's squiggly line money.
That's $50 then. It's $50.
Yeah. $50 fucking.
$50. Yeah. If it's 35 pounds, it's around $50 American.
Oh no. Oh my God. $50 fucking.
Ugh. Yeah, but maybe we can both do it. So it's like splitting it halvesies.
You know what I want? This is what I would love to have happen. Once this thing is legally acquired by somebody else who recorded it legally.
Oh, there it is. Sure. No, because I want to ask questions, Joe.
Oh, you want to ask questions?
I want to ask questions. Come on.
I want every single question that is asked of her. I want to hear them all. And then I want to answer those questions myself.
I'm looking it up right now. So yeah, it's 35 per person. I don't know what the exact translation is, but UKPW.academy.
She's gonna teach a wrestling class or a refereeing class, I'm assuming. By the way, she's refereed now including AEW, like 6 or 7 years. I don't even have to ask you this. I guess I should just present it to the general, listening audience at this point. Does anybody actually believe that she understands how a match is structured or how a match is supposed to go or what she's supposed to do at a match or anything resembling somebody throws her a fucking wild ball or a curveball? Does anybody think she's capable
she
of doing
has
that?
To. She has to. There's no way that she could have gotten away with the last 5 years and not had no idea how to structure a match.
She has no idea, Mish. There's no fucking way she had.
You know what? That would be one of the questions I would ask her.
I would love to. You know what? Oh, my God, dude.
Here we go. Let's read this off. Join us for an exclusive Zoom seminar with AEW referee Aubrey Edwards.
I'm having the poop Zoomies reading this. That's what I'm having.
Tailored for wrestling referees. Oh, Jesus Christ. It's how to be a ref, but open to all roles. This online session will cover everything from positioning basics to storytelling and how the role evolves for TV production. Aubrey will share her expertise, take you behind the scenes, and and answer your questions in this unique opportunity to learn from one of the industry's top referees. Don't miss your chance to gain invaluable insight into the world of pro wrestling.
Don't walk in front of the hard cam. There you go. There's $50 right there for you. Don't get in front of the hard cam.
Oh my God.
Jesus fucking Christ. Yeah, there's $50. Oh my God.
She's talking specifically. You almost have to do this live, Joe. Referees have to do this.
By the way, she's doing this with an earpiece in. These referees. I mean, not that they're actually getting any sort of real instruction, I'm sure, from Tony Khan behind the fucking, the mic. But like they're doing this with earpieces.
You have to do this.
Nothing is happening in these matches that like requires her to have any sort of thought, any sort of on the fly. I know, but you know what?
Yeah.
It forces me to suck my own dick. It really does.
No, it doesn't. You don't have to be, you don't have to self-flagellate. You just have to listen to her, to everything she says, and just go, huh? And then you can unload afterwards. See, during the event, all you have to do is just follow the guidelines. Just be quiet, sit still. Like, you got to be like a lamprey. You got to be underneath the shark, leeching from it. And then once the shark leaves, then you can spit out all the fucking sinew and tissue and shit.
Mish, I'm not sure I can, like, once again, like I said, like I've called whole matches for guys in the ring. I've had green wrestlers on their first fucking match, and I'm in the ring calling this shit for them. I don't even like saying this because once again, it sounds so fucking gross considering how this turned out, but I was in the fucking ring for the very few American matches that Ric Flair fucking had, calling it with Antoine Roar, Tony Roy, who was a classic WWF jobber who helped train Triple H. I was in there with fucking Ric Flair's son helping call a fucking wrestling match. There is no chance on this planet, on this earth, that you could possibly entrust Aubrey Edwards to call anything in a wrestling match that would resemble reasonable, or if she was put in any sort of fucking peril where she needed to come up with something on the fly, she could do it. 0% fucking chance. Don't believe it. Don't buy it. If a guy blew his fucking knee out in the middle of a wrestling match, Aubrey Edwards would probably stand there and with just a dumbfounded fucking look and wait for somebody to come and help her. I mean, this is a part of the reason why whenever people are like, you just hate AEW when you're so salty and this, they ruined wrestling. They actively ruin wrestling, and they take these people who have no fucking idea what they're doing and make them think that they should run teaching seminars online. Not even like I'm going to show up to your fucking wrestling school and try to help people out, which, by the way, charging money for that still is, in my opinion, gross and wrong. If you're supposed to be helping out young people, you're supposed to help them getting better. If you're just popping in somewhere to a school, charging them money is gross and wrong. Ugh. 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 I don't know. I can't. I don't know what to do with this fucking nonsense with these people. They're convinced that they're stars. They're convinced that they're celebrities. They're convinced that they fucking know something. This girl, you couldn't fill all their fucking knowledge about wrestling. You couldn't fill a fucking 2-ounce Dixie cup with it. It's just, did you disappear?
No, I am.
Are you just letting me have a mental breakdown? Because I'm going to have a stroke right now.
What I'm doing is I'm actually making your account for...
I don't want to give this money, dude. I really don't. I really don't. Even at this point, if somebody was like, I'll pay for you to fucking do it, I don't even know if I want to sit there because I'll just be sickened. I'll be sickened. Oh, it'll make Joe. Great. Right. You know what? It'll make great content.
It would be long. Amazing. Are you fucking kidding me? This is literally that pinnacle moment where you get to watch her hang herself. I mean... Because a majority of the people that are probably taking the seminar probably won't have the expertise or experience that you do. But you
I'm not
do
even
have.
An expert. I'm just not dumb.
Okay,
I'm just,
fair enough.
I'm just experienced.
But I'm not expecting people that have 20 years of experience to go, man, maybe Aubrey can teach me something. Like, there's not going to be those type of referees. It's not like one of the Hebners are going to pop out and go, teach me something new, Aubrey. Like.
That's well, who's the one that's dead? Because he still knows more about wrestling than this fucking girl. Well, yeah. Dave? Is Dave the one that died?
Yeah, Dave Hebner. Right.
Yeah, Dave. I still trust Dave Hebner to have a better fucking...
Or Tim White.
Yeah.
Connecticut fucking legend there, Tim White, you know?
Oh, man. But seriously, if you want to do it, the clock is ticking. I think it would be very interesting.
Should we just live stream my face watching this?
No, we'll fucking record the whole goddamn thing. Are you kidding me? I'm gonna capture her goddamn video too. Jesus.
What if we get Don Stevens though? That would be a problem. Don Stevens.
Oh, I'm not worried about us. That. Yeah, so what? Then we make one video on public that isn't fucking monetized. Go fuck yourself.
I know.
You know what I mean? Like, suck my ass. And maybe we even do it. Maybe we even do it where it's only like a 5 or 10 minute clip, because you know this thing's going to be at least an hour. And then we put the full thing up on Patreon.
Oh my God. Could I should, you know, it'd be, I'm just getting evil now. I'm just getting evil, buddy. I'm like, I could fucking.
Joey, this is literally a calling. I'm sorry. I don't know if you see how big this is for a lot of wrestling soup people, but I'm looking at this going, how can you not?
So should I get a nice little, like a, just a little tiny beanie cap?
Oh God, I hope you wear the old blue shirt with the fucking black bow tie. Go straight up WWF 1989.
Mom's spaghetti over here, dude. Yeah. Oh no, you want me to dress like an old?
Yeah, man. Like those old refs from like the WWF, man. None of that zebra shit. You got to wear the blue shirt. Yeah.
So let me ask you this. When a guy is wrapped up in the ropes and the other guy is working him over, what should I do? You mean he's doing a 450 to the outside?
Maybe you can ask her about what bands she knows.
Oh, my God. I mean, this is why, like I said, if you pop into a wrestling school, I mean, you should be there to help. That's just, and I mean that in the same sense that I've seen this happen throughout my fucking life, where it's like people that should have no fucking problem looking at someone and saying, you owe me money for this knowledge. I've seen them give it away. But for
this is your challenge. You know? This is your sword in the stone. This is that moment where for all the years that people that have always shit talked to you as just being a fan, he's just a fan, guys. He doesn't know what the fuck he's talking about. Like, you can use your expertise, your wisdom, your trials, and place that up against the supposed infinite knowledge of one Aubrey Edwards.
I'd get kicked out, probably. No, even just asking like a real question, like not even framing it in a shitty way or a rude way.
Hold on a second. Let's take a look at the rules of doing this. So there's a list of rules.
There's rules.
So the terms and conditions for the event attendance: by purchasing a ticket and attending the Grapple Academy Zoominar or online event, you agree to the following terms and conditions. Ticket policy: each ticket is purchased for one person only. Access to the event. Maybe I will buy a second ticket. Who knows? And I'll just shut up, do a black screen so I can record everything. As limited to the ticket holder, the ticket is non-transferable. Attendees will be cross-referenced with ticket purchases prior to entry.
Yeah, there it is. Cross-reference. They'll fucking...
Says to ensure proper access.
Yeah.
No, I think that's more along the lines to make sure that there isn't two people on the same line. I think that's what it is. Oh,
come on.
Recording and usage of content. Uh-oh. The event will be recorded for internal feedback and developmental purposes. You may also be used in future promotional content, including but not limited to social media marketing. By attending the event, you consent to your likeness, voice, any questions, comments you make during the event being recorded and potentially used in any future, blah, 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 blah.
AKA, we're going to charge you money to ask her questions to then sell that media of you asking questions.
What a coincidence. So are we.
That is fantastic. Yeah. Well, guess what? We got the same idea too, bucko. Good idea. I think I'll do the same.
You acknowledge that your participation in the event gives UKPW the full rights to use, edit, and distribute the content without the need for further consent or compensation. So do you, pal. So do you. Prohibited activities. Ah, here we go. No filming or recording any part of the event. This rule will result in the attendee being removed from the event immediately without the possibility of refund.
How are you going to know that weeks down the line? But right.
Followed
how
by
how do they fucking know that?
No refund policy. Like they're saying, without the possibility of a refund, but literally the next thing they have is no refund policy. Refunds are not issued if you're unable to attend. Exceptions may be made on a case-by-case basis, but any request for a refund must be made 48 hours prior to the event. That's it. So no refunds, period.
Hi, I'm Dutch Mantel. I can't make it to the I can't make it to the Aubrey seminar because I need to learn so much. And I'm using $50 of the $5,000 that Tony Khan gave to me because he's so fucking generous. I'm sorry. I can't make it. What's the date on it again?
It's November 9th, right? Yeah, the 9th.
Damn. Oh, damn.
$35 plus fees. What are fees? Let's see what fees are. Hold on a minute. Let's go back. Let's add. So how much are two tickets? Get tickets. Oh, it's a $7 booking fee. Is that what it said? $99.48.
What?
For both of us.
Oh, okay. I'm like, whew.
Yeah. But I was right. It was $50 for 35 pounds. Yeah, that's basically what it is.
Oh, my God. Damn it. Damn it. This might have to show. Might have to mom spaghetti this.
Joe. Maybe you could put on a wig or something, or maybe a mustache. Get one of those crazy goggles with the fake nose and the mustache on it. Be incognito.
Dude. Oh, if only I had a Lucha mask.
Wait a minute. I'm sorry. I was wrong. It's 6 p.m. GMT. It's 1 p.m. Eastern.
Oh, so it's a little, so it's lunch with Aubrey.
For you. Yes.
She's in England. Is that what it said?
It's a Zoom call. So it's based out of England, but she could still be here. Right.
Do you think that the referees in AEW have a hard time keeping track of the number of times that it's the same move that the guy kicks out of at what time he's supposed to actually get pinned?
Sounds like a question for Aubrey.
I know. So is it ever tough when you're sitting there and it's, hey, on the fourth Canadian destroyer, that's when you gotta count to three. You know what I mean? You're sitting there, you're like, shit, which number Canadian destroyer is this? Because this is a huge thing. This is like a huge part of actually refereeing matches that make sense. Where's the amulet? Whatever the fuck. What is this?
How do you ref?
Where's the goddamn finish? Where is it? When's it actually happen? God damn it. No, that's
all that the kisses. Me, look, all the kisses from Aubrey. You can have all the kisses on your face.
No, those are all from Elsa Banks.
Oh,
those are Elsa Banks.
They do look infectious. Now you gotta go,
dude, I was going to say, now you got to go get a, fucking, get tested. Oh,
Jesus.
Yeah, that will do wonders for me.
That'll do nicely.